Let's go, recruits. Let's go. Hustle, hustle, hustle. Move, move.
Wait, you want to be a cop? Honey, that's so dangerous.
Mom, please. It's what I want to do with my life.
Out there you could be hurt, or even killed.
I don't care about that. I care about meaning something in this world. When people look back on me, I want them to remember me for the good I've done. I can't take you to heaven.
I can't save your soul. Men! What do we do here?
Train, sir.
Why do we train?
To protect and serve,
sir.
But Sal, is it worth the risk? Putting your life on the line for people you don't even know?
It's not just about the risk. It's about the reward of knowing that you've made the world a better place.
Cruz, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
And begin.
I'll need help along the way, but this is my goal. And I will do everything I can to see it be done.
Come on. Come on, hit it hard. Wait, I'm not done yet. I want to try again.
What? All right, let's do it again. All right, gentlemen. Round two. We don't normally do this, but Sal wants to prove himself. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Begin. All right, good job, Sal. Way to go. Way to go.
You think they're what we're looking for?
We'll see.
Hey, Sal.
Hey, Joey.
You okay? Oh, come on, what's wrong?
It's just... I can't do this anymore, Joey.
What? Hiking duty?
All of this!
What, being a cop?
I mean...
Hey! Remember the promise we made in the academy?
Yes, Joey, I remember. I just feel that I didn't want to do this. By this point, I thought that I would have been, I don't know, out there saving people. Not writing parking violations. I don't know, man. I thought there'd be more to this.
What's your shift tomorrow?
What do you think?
Sorry, man.
Don't be. You have it too.
What? See you later.
see you.
This car's been here for days. I don't even know why we bother.
Just tag the rest of the cars so we can get out of here.
Forget it, man. It's not like we're ever gonna pay for them. These cars are pretty much abandoned.
Come on, Joey.
Oh my god, are you serious? I was in there for 2 hours. I can't take this ticket. So what you can do is take your little pen and pad and shove it.
Man, that's reserved parking.
Oh yeah? Reserve that. Thanks a lot, assholes.
I hate this job.
Joey.
Come on, Sal.
Joey, look!
What are you doing?
In your purse.
Oh my god!
Did that really just happen?
Yeah. You're under arrest. All right, you got her? All right, see you.
Do you think they're ready?
As ready as they're gonna be. You made up your mind yet?
Yes.
So we're doing this then? For real?
Meet me at the station. We have work to do.
Well, alright then.
Signed up for, Joey.
Then we'll get promoted?
God, I hope so.
Sal.
That's what we've been working for years.
Sal.
What?
There's no tag. You should take a look at this.
It's from Walker.
What?
Son, I was just calling to see how you're doing. I haven't heard from you in a while, and I just wanted to check up on you.
How's city life treating you? When you first told me that you're going to become a cop, I was really worried about you putting yourself in danger. But you seem to be making it just fine. You know I love you. See ya.
Didn't this guy say 11? Oh, it's well past 11.
Hey, look.
That's them. Let's go. Fergus, my man.
Not today, Jonas.
Oh, what changed?
Well, people are not happy.
Well, we're not having any customer service right now, but we're willing to ask sometime in the future.
You know what this is about? Marco. Product is shit. It's a dud, Jonas. All of it is. You sold me shit. I didn't realize you were scamming your customers.
Not all my customers.
I'm in deep with the loan sharks. I'm trying to keep my customers happy. You promised me a good product, I want my money back now.
I just forgot we don't do refunds here. So I suggest that you turn around back to your little hired muscle back there and leave.
I've dealt with you for 2 years, but I've had enough. I want to speak to your brother.
Your dealings are with me.
Honestly, I just don't even care anymore. Where is he? Red is it? He runs the whole operation. Hello? I want to speak to the guy in charge. Finally, the man is here.
I understand you have an issue with some of my product.
Yeah, I do. I don't know how you're making this shit, but it ain't working.
Well, I would be happy to help one of our largest distributors.
Finally, someone who makes sense around here.
However, we do take issues with complaints about our product.
Hey! Look who you're aiming at. You really want to be the guy that shoots Red?
Nah, shit.
What the hell was that?
Jonas, were you selling the fake cocaine?
Okay, look, it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter? Were you selling the fake cocaine?
Okay. Only the Fergus, all right?
So you were selling the fake cocaine?
Look, we're tied on money, not that Mr. Shortcuts, all right? It's only a couple of crates.
Shortcuts? This is our reputation, our father's reputation.
It was only the Fergus, it doesn't matter.
Guys.
Does it matter? Our company has been a clean slate from the beginning.
Look. He's my client. You assigned him to me.
It doesn't matter who it's assigned.
Guys! Listen.
Cops.
Someone saw us.
Well, it's probably the guard.
You had the guard get away?
It doesn't matter. We need to get out of here.
Thank you.
You're Lieutenant Walker, I'm Sal Lopez.
And you're late.
I'm sorry, my alarm didn't go off this morning. Please.
Your partner was on time, Lopez. Maybe you should have been as well.
Guys, I promise this never happened.
We know
guys.
Your record. Sal Lopez, 22, male. Been here for 2 years, no infractions, suspensions, nothing. Congratulations.
Sorry, who are you?
Detective Kirk Walker to you, best damn detective in the whole station. You'd know that if you
That's
were
enough, Kirk.
Ask Langston what the details of the mission are.
Please, sir, just give me one more chance.
Follow me. Let me ask you a question. Do you know what we do here?
Criminal investigations.
Besides the name the state he's given us, he's asking you what we do here.
I don't know how to answer that question.
This isn't your run-of-the-mill operation, Lopez.
This is the type of thing you don't hear about on the news, the type of thing people die over. Alright, I know you guys thought you were tough shit the other day with that thief, but it's nothing like what you're going up against.
The moment you join our squad, Sal Lopez and Joey Langston no longer exist. Your records are wiped.
That means you were never here, you were never cops, you were never born.
Harrison Redmayne, better known as Red, he's the leader of the Redmayne Crime Syndicate, as they're known officially.
These guys have been around for years. What makes you think we can stop them?
We didn't make you come here today. You made that choice yourself. But if you're successful, you'll be known as the guys that took down one of the biggest crime families in U.S. history. So, are you in or are you out?
Alright then, what's the job?
Red's cartel has been a dot on the map for decades, but only recently have we seen major expansion. Last year, the head of the syndicate, William Redmayne, passed the torch down to his son, Harrison.
Now that the old man's out of the way, Harrison's free to expand as he wishes, and so he has. This guy's lining the pockets of cops, bankers, politicians, you name it, and they all turn a blind eye. I mean, he has single-handedly run the cartel behind bars, the one time we were able to get him for something. Growth has made him powerful. But with growth, there's also risk.
And that's where you two come into play. You guys are going undercover as two ex-cons that want to work for Red.
That means two new identities.
Joey Langston, as of now, you're Jeremy Lambert. Sal Lopez, you are now Samuel Delgado.
You two need to have these identities memorized front to back because your lives and the mission depend on it.
Okay, but how do we get inside the hotel?
Well, unfortunately, you won't be able to just walk in and handcuff Red. He may be expanding, but it's not stupid.
He rarely leaves the business, and even when he does, he's well protected. Luckily, we have another way in.
That's right. He's got a brother.
Jonas Redmayne. He's second born to William and second in command to Red. He's reckless, and combining that with power is a recipe for disaster.
That disaster is our way in.
So how do we get in close with this Jonas guy?
Recently, Red has allowed Jonas to recruit his own men and even do dealings of his own. That's our end.
You two are gonna get recruited by Red. Cozy up to him. It's the long con, boys.
We'll likely have to build Jonas' trust before Red will get close to you.
You've got our message.
Of course. We could always use some new guys.
He's clear.
Sam Delgado.
Jonas Redmayne.
Obviously. It's great to finally meet you.
Of course.
He's clear.
Jeremy Lambert.
Oh, I know who you guys are.
So you know what we're here for?
Yeah, I did my research. Yeah, I went through everything I could find on you two. Gotta say, I'm impressed. Well, you two come to me for a job. Times are tough.
I mean, what is it? 8, 9, 10 counts of armed robbery, extortion, assault.
I mean, and what, less than 5 years combined in prison for all of it?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
He's got one hell of a lawyer.
Yeah, one hell of a lawyer.
Well, safe to say, you two got the job.
Get in.
Since you're both still alive, I assume it went well, right?
Well, you could say that.
Welcome to the HQ. Jerry, Sam, with me. This is one of our many locations, but here is where I like to do business.
Who is it?
I'll be right back.
He knows not a good time, Walter.
Where's the other guy?
Who is this?
Pete. He's working with you and Jeremy.
Hey.
What's up?
So is that it?
Yeah, you can leave now.
All according to plan, it seems. Now, just build trust with Jonas. After a while, you'll be able to get in contact with Red, but we have no idea how long that could take. It could be weeks, months, or even years. Here. There's gonna be long stretches of time where we don't have face-to-face contact. If you need me, or if anything develops, a number will be in there. Good luck.
Wait. What do we do now?
How am I supposed to know? You work for Jonas now.
All right, guys. This will be a normal job. No funny business. Down! Where's the gun? Give him the money.
It's all I have. $650 worth of it.
Better be all. I don't want to come back.
Another week.
Sure we can't keep this?
Yeah. Theft, drug deals, coercion, business as usual.
And nobody has caught on to either one of you.
Not as far as I can tell. I just don't feel like we're getting anywhere, you know?
Just be patient, Sal. This is gonna take some time, but you're on the right track. Just keep it up.
Whatever you say, boss.
Let's do this.
Get down! He on the ground!
I've waited too long for this. Where's my money at? Right now, give me my money.
I don't have any money.
Give me my money.
I swear I don't have any money.
I swear, I will blow your brains out. Give me my money.
I don't have any money.
Man, bro, I'm gonna get out of here. Come on,
fuck.
If you wanted us to be any more out of place, we'd have to go to a circus.
Just enjoy the evening, Kirk.
What took you so long? You look like you got hit by a damn bus.
Shut the fuck up, Kirk.
Hey, you need to relax, Lopez. You're the one who called this meeting in the first place.
Did something happen on the job? I've been busting my ass for Jonas for months now, and we've made no progress. Sal, this is a long operation. You knew that when we signed you up for this. I'm losing it, Lieutenant. Every day I risk my life because of the psychos that Jonas is dealing with. I can't even sleep at night because I'm scared that some guy who I pissed off is gonna pull a bullet in my head. Sal, a process like this is going to have a toll on you. Do you know what I've had to do for this operation, Lieutenant? I almost had to beat a bastard to death because he couldn't afford to pay for Red's protection and feed his cake at the same damn time. Listen, you've gotten a lot closer to Jonas from when you started. He trusts you. All I'm asking you to do is keep it up for a couple more months, then Red will want to meet you. I signed up for this operation so I could take a drug lord down, not do their dirty work. I don't think I can do this much longer if it's not going to get us anywhere closer to putting Red in handcuffs.
Stop with this act, boy. You know what we're here to talk about.
Of course I'm ready, but...
But what, Harrison? The fact of the matter is that Ferguson and his men were a premium contact that both of our families have used for years. Now he's in the ER with a slim chance of ever speaking again.
With all due respect, I know the implications of what happened, and I understand that my organization is to blame.
You're a young man to lead such a lucrative family. I want to see you thrive. That's why I'll settle for a deal.
That's manageable.
Because of the gravity of the situation, I think 8 blocks is more than generous on my behalf.
Are you kidding me? 8 blocks? That's worth at least 10 million in clients. Who do you think you are?
Harrison, I suggest that you put a leash on your little brother before he gets the both of you in trouble that a simple deal can get you out of.
I have, of course. Jonas, not now.
Wait a second, Harry. You cannot be serious right
now. I said not now.
Make the necessary arrangements. We're done here. Get yourself together, Harrison. Don't ruin your father's legacy.
What the hell was that? You little muck all over you right there. What happened?
Brady's a longtime business associate and family friend. I had to do whatever I could to make him happy. It was my fault.
What happened to your plan of expansion? We were supposed to overtake assholes like him.
Now is not the time to be making enemies. I don't want to talk about this right now.
Wait. Wait, Harry. Listen, you want to take this guy down, right? We need to show him who the fuck he is messing with.
Listen, Jonas, this world's a lot more complicated than that. The whole organization could fall by messing with the wrong guy. Know your enemies from your friends.
I do.
Thanks for bringing me out here.
Of course. Tell your mom I said hi.
Keep going.
Hey. Didn't know you had a kid.
I don't. He's my nephew.
How are they doing?
Lopez and Langston? Jonas trusts them. Now all they have to do is get a meeting with Red.
You don't think the phone call from Joey was a little suspicious? We haven't heard from him since then.
We've gone over this 100 times. They'll call us when they need us.
I don't know, dude. This is getting too high stakes. We need
Kirk!
To...
I know what this is about, okay? I said I'm sorry, Kirk, but I just don't think you would be as useful out in the field as you are with me.
You're not sorry. You say you are, but you're not.
Listen to
me! No, you listen to me! You and I both know I was the most qualified man for the job. We've been working on this case for how long? And you sent a couple nobodies in there to get shot and killed? It should have been me out there, not them! So what? So you could get shot instead of them? Did you not think I didn't think it through? Did you not think that I didn't consider you for the job? It's not about what's fair, Kirk!
It's about
what?
It's about who I'm willing to lose, okay? Is that what you wanted to hear? You're right, I'm not sorry for not putting your life in danger when I need you the most.
Better be for a good reason.
coming, Harry.
You said you had two of them that deep fit to speak with me.
Yeah. I work with them for a couple months now. They're great.
I always need more men. I assume you take them through the vetting process.
Of course.
What is this?
Just business, Harry. I'm just cutting off loose ends.
You're my brother.
You were my brother, Harry. Back before Dad left you with the keys of the business and you left me nothing.
I've been fair to you. We've been there for each other.
Fair? Is fair leaving me in the shadows where you got all the fame and the fortune?
What do you want from me?
Ever since you took control, you ran this business to the ground. You trampled over small-time crooks like Fergus, but you kneeled on men like Moriarty.
You think you can run this organization?
Better than you. Pete.
Think you control his whole organization? You can't even control him.
Father trigger, Pete.
Look at yourself.
Do it.
Father would have been disappointed in you. Pete, pull the trigger!
I can't.
You're a disgrace to the family.
Downstairs. We got work to do.
Get in.
Some adjustments.
Jonas, I don't know.
I've heard enough excuses, Sam. Or should I say, Sal?
I don't know what you're talking
about. Just stop. I know who you are. I know what you do. I know you're a cop. I know you work for Walker. And I know you're a fucking mole. You got nothing to say?
How do you find out?
Are you there? Joey? Christ.
I figured it was one of you two. You or Pete. So I talked to Pete. But luckily for him, your pal Joey showed up.
Where is he?
Very cooperative. He told us every little thing about your operation.
I'm sorry.
It's over, Sal. You're fucked. Send a message to Lieutenant Walker.
Fuck you!
Tell your boss
that I don't want any more fucking pigs in my syndicate. I want them all out.
Jeez. We should have seen it coming. The signs were here the whole time.
I'm sorry, Sal. I'm at fault for what happened.
Don't blame yourself.
It was my responsibility to keep them alive.
You know what? You're right. It is your fucking fault.
Hey, why don't you watch yourself, Lopez?
Go fuck yourself.
Sal.
It's your fault too, Detective. You both sent us out there.
Excuse me? We were not the ones who were out in the field. How do you expect us to know what was gonna happen?
It's your job, Detective, to put the pieces together. You should have warned us.
And what do you expect me to do, Sal? You want me to just zap myself back in time and change what happened?
You have a dead man on your conscience. You tell me.
My conscience? You knew the risks of the job when you took it up.
Kirk, that's enough.
I knew the risks? We were a bunch of nobodies. Why would you send us into a mission like that?
We thought that you were a team we could keep under control. We did not know that you couldn't keep your identities under wraps.
You can't expect to send in a bunch of rookies and expect everything to go perfectly.
It's not my fault, all right? You thought I wanted a couple rookies on this case? You thought it was my choice? I've been on the case for 5 years! You think I was just perfectly happy with letting a couple rookies on the scene? No, it was Walker's idea, not mine. Don't you dare look at me like it was anybody but Joey's fault that he got himself killed.
Stop! That's enough!
What's done is done. We can't change it. We have to live with it. It's over.
You're right.
It is over.
Great job. Now we've lost both of them. What do you expect us to do now?
Didn't know you started smoking again.
Fuck off, Kirk.
Packing up, what does it look like?
No. What are you doing?
Sal may be an asshole, but he was right about one thing. Case is over.
can't believe that happened, Sal. I'm sorry. Joey was a good friend of yours.
Yeah, that's been hard.
I'm just glad that you're okay.
Well, you'll be happy to know that you won't have to worry about it anymore.
What do you mean?
I quit the force. I'm not a cop anymore.
You're not? I don't understand. I thought this was your dream.
I thought you'd be happy about this. You're the one that didn't want me to be a cop, right?
I've accepted the dangers that come with your line of work. I didn't think it was my place to stop you from doing what you wanted to do.
That's just not it. I can't go back there, knowing what's happened.
That job meant the world to you, Sal. I know it's difficult, knowing that Joey was lost there. But I know you have it in you to face it. It was you that wanted to make a difference, right?
No, listen to me. Did it come through yet?
I'm looking at all of them right now.
Well, get on it then!
But sir, these files are completely out of order.
Tell that to Quinn, not me. That's not my department.
So you don't want to see them?
No.
But, sir!
Who hires the people around here?
Why'd you call me here?
It's about last night.
Oh, God. Jeez, Walker, I thought we talked about this already.
I'm sorry, Kirk, but I can't just drop this now after everything we've accomplished.
Look, I get it. But Langston died and Lopez quit. We've hit a dead end.
How long have we been working on this case together? You said yourself last night that we can't just give up this easily.
Harrison Redmayne is dead. He was our target. Now he's gone.
So you're out then?
I'm sorry, Walker. I wish it could have ended differently.
Hello?
Lieutenant.
Sal?
Lopez?
Sal, what are you doing?
I changed my mind.
I'm taking Jonas down.
What? Wait, Sal, what do you mean? I'm headed to the HQ now.
Now? What does he mean now?
Sal, we have to plan this out.
No, Lieutenant.
I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing this for me. I just thought you'd want to know.
What? Wait!
Sal!
What the hell is he thinking? And what are you-
You're driving.
What?
Let's go.
Someone else?
You know what I'm here for.
Because of Jeremy?
Because of everything!
You gonna kill me?
No. I'm bringing you in.
I wouldn't be so sure about that.
Drop the weapon.
Took it long enough. I tried to let you walk away and you didn't take it. It's too late now. Sweet for any of this. It ends now. Duke?
Duke, listen to me.
You brought your friends?
No, I didn't bring anyone.
Duke, deal with it.
Alright, so we need to make sure Sal is safe, and then we can vote from there. Motherfucker!
walked away.
Down here then. We're gone.
Stop! It's over.
Cleanup crew's on its way. Let's go.
I tell you, I work for long years for a woman, and she has the nerve to put me out. Trucking steel like a slave. 5 long years every Friday. I went straight home with all of my pay. You ever been mistreated before? Then you know just what I'm talking about. I tell you, I work 5 long years for a woman, and she has enough.